Katy Perry. It's a name usually emblazoned outside stadiums all over the world. But today it was being sung by lawyers in the federal court. The pop star and a lesser-known Sydney fashion designer of the same name are going to war.
From this small space in Paddington, this Australian designer is running a business, a label and a lawsuit, pitting her showroom against America's showstopper.
What's the point of having an Australian trademark if overseas companies can come in and just breach it?
That trademark is for Katy Perry loungewear, born as a market stall 14 years ago, before that other Katy Perry started making hits. And crucially, started making clothes.
I'm Katy Perry, and I'm here with my latest collection.
A decade ago, lawyers for the singing superstar sent a cease and desist, prompting this plea.
I welcome you to come and visit my studio when you do come here for your concert in August. But at the moment, the only people who are making any money from this are the lawyers.
That was dropped, but today, the battle of Katy against Katy was back in the federal court.
The American Katy Perry's clothes are sold here at Myer, and while the lawyers argue over copyright, the Australian Katy Perry believes she has an advantage of her own.
I'm Australian owned, I'm Australian made, I am Australian. So there is that sense of pride around this and the fact that this is an overseas conglomerate, nothing to do with Australia.
The case will return for trial later this year. Charles Croucher, Nine News.